Hello everyone and welcome to another video of mine. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Trek to Yomi. Let me quickly get my earbuds on and I think we should be good to go. Now, this game is pretty interesting because it's actually a 2.5D platformer. It's not exactly 3D. It's not 2D as well because you can travel like vertically and horizontally. So it's kind of like 3D, I'm not sure. I think it's a 2.5D platformer, more on those lines. Now, as always, let me give you information about this game. And while I'm playing this game, I'll also let you know about my experience with the game. Now, as far as the game goes, it's a side-scrolling, you could say a platformer. It's developed by a company called Flying Wild Hog. That's a weird name, isn't it? And it's published by Devolver Digital. Now, the game has been released for Windows. It's been released for PlayStation 4, for PlayStation 5, Xbox One, Xbox Series X, and Xbox Series S. And it got released in the month of May. So, just this month, that is. And the game, it's set in this Edo period of Japan. And it's in Japanese, by the way. So you're going to be playing this game with subs, like subtitles. And you're going to be playing as this character called Hiroki, who goes on this journey. And what's this journey? Well, it's basically a journey to confront the people who are responsible for destroying his village. So that's the story of Trek to Yomi in a gist and what the game is about. Now, it's available on almost all the platforms. So even if you have an Xbox One, you will still be able to enjoy this. Now, I'm playing this on my Xbox Series S. The install size on the Xbox Series S is 7.5 GB. And it's incredible because this game runs at 4K on your Xbox Series S. Yes, even on your Series S, it will run at 4K. And it's going to be running at 60 frames per second. Isn't that amazing? So you've got a game which is less than 10 gigabytes. Runs at 4K, 60 FPS on your Xbox Series S. Now, the way the game looks is pretty unique and pretty fantastic, I must say. All right. Now, if you are a fan of these vintage Japanese movies, then you're definitely going to appreciate this game. This game has that vibe, that feel. In fact, there are even filters that you can use where you can actually add in that, you know, retro vintage kind of feel and even film grain. So you can add in film grain, you can add in this filter, which makes it look more like a classic Japanese movie. And even when you play this game, these are just the slight tutorials that you will have to go through. Every game kind of has this. And it's very short. It's not a lengthy tutorial. Like, for instance, if you play a game like Final Fantasy 15, yeah, 15, for instance, well, the tutorial is quite long. This game is pretty straightforward. The gameplay is pretty straightforward. You're just a swordsman. And as a swordsman, you're just going to slice and dice, hack and slash your way through this village, this Japanese village. Kind of a setting. So the two modes of attack, you attack from the bottom up and from the top to bottom. You can even reverse yourself because if there are enemies coming in from all sides, meaning enemies from behind you as well, then you can have like a quick reverse as well. And then you have a parry or a counter attack, and then you can, you know, just block the attack. And yeah, I mean, reverse the attack that was being done on you. So it's very straightforward, very simple, nothing complex. And it kind of reminds me of those good old days where game controls were not as complicated as they are today, where I even have to look at the controls list going into the options. So even if you do not go through this tutorial, just by button mashing, I think you'll be able to find your way out as to how this game needs to be played. It's that simple. Is it effective? I think it is, all right? And that's why, you know, I play these games so that I can tell you, if you want to skip the tutorial, then hey, I mean, you totally can. If you just want to skip it. So it's a very simple, straightforward game. Now, the graphics on this game, let me talk about that. I don't know if you're noticing the graphics, but it is impressive, to say the least. I'm not saying that because this is in 4K 60 FPS. Well, while I was playing this game, I decided to put my television, or put my console rather, my Xbox Series S, on 1080p with the 120 Hz option. Now, I do have a television which actually supports full HD in 120 Hz. And that was the option that I decided to go along with while I was playing this game. And let me tell you that my experience on this game is a joyful experience. I mean, it is so smooth. It plays like butter. And the beauty about Xbox Series S and X is that it gives you that much more freedom. In fact, I've recently made a few videos on PS5 VRR. And I've spoken about the limitations that come along with the implementation of VRR in PlayStation 5 and how Xbox is comparatively superior or better simply because of the fact that it actually works with more monitors and more televisions, because it is not just limiting your VRR experience to HDMI 2.1, but you can actually experience VRR even with an HDMI 2.0 monitor or television, because my Samsung AU9070 is exactly that. It's an HDMI 2.0 television, but it supports VRR. It also supports 1080p at 120 Hz. And I'm playing this game on 1080p, 120 Hz. I think it claims to have 4K 60 FPS, but I think it might even have unlocked frames. Now, the reason why I say that is because when I play games with an unlocked frame rate, the frames in my Samsung game, console, it kind of varies between 119 to say about 48. So it kind of shows you those dips. And that's exactly what I was getting with this game, which can only mean one thing, that this game actually has an unlocked frame rate. And when I play this game, I'm again, not exaggerating, but simply emphasizing on how smooth this game looks on my Xbox Series S. And as far as the visual setting of this game goes, it brings this old, you could say, Japanese village to life. There's so many characters in the background. Look at all the small cart on wheels, and those lamps in the background, those vegetable vendors, those fruit sellers. You've got a pumpkin that I can see out there. Those large water jars, rice bags, these people in the foreground as well. And the use of motion blur is so beautifully done. I mean, just take a look at the background right now. Even the use of light, I'm just moving around the place so that I can just show you how you can move around vertically and horizontally in the game. So it gives you that sense that you're in this 3D world. So it's not a 2D platformer. Although the wiki information, if you go over to the wiki information of this game, it will tell you that it's a side-scrolling action game. But it's not exactly side. I mean, you can move around vertically as well, as you're probably seeing in the video right now. Now look at those leaves on the trees, the temple in the background. This game has nailed the whole old Japanese village setting beautifully. Nailed to the T. Spot on. It is beautiful. You can even sprint, by the way. I just kind of realized that. So you can sprint your way across the village as well. I'm just trying to figure out, you know, what to do, where to go. And it's a very simple, straightforward game. I was just a little distracted with what I needed to show. So don't think that this game is very difficult. In fact, it's one of the easiest games that I've played. The combat as well is pretty straightforward and very simple. Now, everything is in Japanese, so you would have to play this game in Japanese. That's the only option. There are English subtitles, so of course, you can follow them and understand how the story is flowing. And you know, when you play these games in the language that it was meant to be in, like originally made, I think it feels more authentic. It feels more lively for some reason. Although I don't understand Japanese, I kind of appreciate the fact that it has been made in Japanese. It just goes to show how much they appreciate the culture, the game developers, that is. And they wanted to make sure that they give you this entire experience in the original way it was intended to be in, the Japanese way. And yeah, as you can see, you know, so you've moved from the outdoors to the indoors, and the lighting is so beautifully done. I mean, I'm absolutely in awe of how beautiful this game looks. And lighting plays a very important part when you play a game. Bad lighting can make a beautiful game look ugly, and good lighting can actually make, I wouldn't say an ugly, but an okay or a mediocre game also look spectacular. And in this game, the levels are designed beautifully. Look at that those god rays coming in, and the dust particles, and the film grain or the motion film filter just gives you that cinematic feel. And it's, while I was playing this game, trust me, I felt like it was more a movie than a game. And if a game has succeeded in doing that, then I think the game has got your attention and you're enjoying the game. The backdrops are so meticulously and beautifully designed. I mean, everything oozes with detail. And it goes to show that how much time they've spent in fine-tuning this Japanese village setting. And definitely appreciated. This is definitely appreciated. Kudos to the team who have actually designed and developed this. Those water jars, take a look at that. And the foreground and the background, they're blurred. And the focus is on the main character and your companion for this journey. For now, you're Hiroki, and you've got a small little teeny little friend along with you. And this village is full of life, by the way. You've got people doing their daily work, selling in the background. They're cutting wood, chop wood, carry water kind of stuff. And the village, the level, everything breeds life. I mean, look at this scene. Oh my God, it's incredible. And this game is a must play. And I would highly recommend that you get your hands on this game, because, hey, it's anyways available on Game Pass. And that's the beauty of Xbox Series X, S, and even the Xbox One. You've got Game Pass. So you don't even need to pay for this game additionally. Just download it on Game Pass. And I will, again, mention, I highly recommend that you do. It's a fabulous cinematic experience. Now, I know there are going to be comparisons with Ghost of Tsushima. I think it's singular, not plural. So Ghost of Tsushima is a brilliant game. I will never deny that. But the feel and the way that game is designed is very different to this game. That's a complete 3D game. And although, you know, this is also three-dimensional, because I don't think this is actually a side-scrolling 2D platformer. You have 3D elements in this. But overall, this game is very different. You have fixed camera angles. You do not have the freedom to look at whatever things you want to look at, like in Ghost of Tsushima. It's not a free-roaming game. So it's not exactly an open-world game. So the storytelling lets you follow this very linear path, because that's the way these levels have been designed. But it is incredible. I know, leaving the comparisons with Ghost of Tsushima, this game can stand on its own merit. That's how good this game is. So I don't think this is trying to rip off Ghost of Tsushima or any other game like that. This game has an identity of its own. It is unique. It is really quite an experience. I mean, so far, I went into the game with a lot of hesitation, because first of all, I'm not really a fan of these type of games, you know, these 2.5 or 2D platformers or side-scrolling games. I don't play a lot of them. If you have seen my channel, you know that I generally play games which are like Assassin's Creed, like open world, free roaming, action adventure, RPGs. So this game kind of surprised me because I found myself wanting to play more. And in any game where I have that experience, I specifically mentioned that in my video, because if you have a person who's not used to playing this game, and if a game has been able to attract you to play it more, then of course the game has done its job. And this game has very little, you could say, cutscenes, but it's all beautifully woven into the gameplay. So you are out there roaming around a lot more than you would view these cutscenes. And these cutscenes are sharp. They're really beautiful. And the transition between the cutscenes to gameplay is seamless. This is like a Japanese Western, you know, Japanese samurai kind of a movie. And you're about to engage in a duel. The gameplay, again, I would like to mention, very straightforward, very simple. Ooh, all right. So there you go. Simple. Oh. So it's either top to bottom, bottom to top, and you charge right in front, and you can parry as well. Now, even if you lose health, the good thing is that there are various mini temples across the different levels that you pass through, and you'd be able to save your progress and also regenerate your health. Even the fog or the smoke effect, the smoke's been done really well. I mean, this game, oh man, I mean, just look at it. It kind of reminds me of these younger days of mine where we would play with our toys, these tiny little G.I. Joes or He-Man figurines. And, you know, you would have these castle or these setup that you would have at your, bedroom table or something like that, where you have miniature, you could say, adventures happening on your table. You have stories being told in your mind. Kind of reminded me of those days. Because this game actually looks like that. You know, you have these characters who look like these miniature figurines set in this beautiful Japanese village environment. And it is telling an effective story. It's, so far, I'm engaged. And I appreciate, you know, what they're doing with this game. And I think if more and more developers try to come up with something like that or this, then gamers will definitely appreciate it because it has this uniqueness about it. It is original, and it's got my attention. It's beautiful. And I don't know if you noticed how the background blurs as you move towards the camera. Even here, I mean, what I would love to see is, I know this game was meant to be played in black and white with the film grain, etc. and all that, but I am curious to find out how this game would actually look in color, because I'm sure that even in color, this game will look beautiful. The levels are so beautifully designed that, of course, you know, you are going to wonder how this game would look in color, I mean, in all its glory. So I'd be very interested to see if the developers can actually come out with an option in the future through an update where they offer that mode, where I can play this game in full-blown color mode instead of playing this in black and white. Although the black and white does have a nice feel to it, it kind of gives it its own uniqueness. But yeah, more of the modes, always better. Now, the camera angle as well. Look at the leaf in the leaves in the foreground. So cinematic, isn't it? And the shadows, etc. Everything in this game looks really sharp. And again, this game runs at 4K 60 FPS on your Xbox Series S. Yeah, so this is one of those games where if you've just got an Xbox Series S and no Series X, you can still show off the 4K capabilities of your Xbox Series S. You can just call your friend and say, hey, you know what? This game is running at 4K. And you know what? The icing on the cake at 60 FPS. Yes. So that is what is great about this game. And I would again like to mention that this game, I will highly recommend that you do play this game because it is brilliant in every way. I was pleasantly surprised with how beautiful this game looks and plays as well. So I had a great time with this, and I'm confident that you would too as well. So that's why I, again, would like to mention that play this game, guys. Play this. It's on Game Pass anyways. What have you got to lose? Nothing. Yeah. So with that said, I think I'll end this video here today. And do let me know your thoughts, your comments in the comment section as to what you feel about this game. If you have played this game after watching this video, I'd be very interested to find out what you personally feel about this game. So with that said, we come to the end of this video. But before I say it's a wrap for this one, I will like to take this moment to request you to hit that like and subscribe button if you've liked this content, and also that bell icon in case you look forward to more videos of mine. Because every time I put up a video of mine, you get notifications when you hit that bell icon. Now with that said, finally, it's a wrap for this one. And I'll see you lovely folks in my next video. Until that time, I'll say take care, stay safe, and may God bless you all.